Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, we are continuing our Laravel e-commerce series, which is all about our cart page now. So guys, as you can see, we needed the quantity things. So here you can see that it is the input type number one. So when we click up, it's incrementing and decrementing because this is input number type, right? So number type, I mean to say this input as type as number. So it's give me increment and decrement. So that thing, but we don't need that format. We need something else design, and we need to do in jQuery format. So we can, when we click update, that time the quantity should get updated with this proper and show the grand total. Done. So guys, for that, first let's do the quantity design for this and do the increment and decrement format for this now. So guys, in this video, we are going to continue how to make a quantity increment and decrement using jQuery. Done. So first let us go and see. This is our cart page where we are showing this output. So I'll just show you a demo that we are here itself. Let me type with and let me comment this and let's see the output. So cool. So as you can see with this, I'm here itself. Done. So now in this place, we have to place our quantity design. So guys, I have already posted on my blog where this link is given into our video description. And now we have to do with this quantity design means we will copy this. So I have used Bootstrap 4 to design this 4.5 version right now. So let me paste it. So let's take out full and paste that. That's it. So now guys, what we have to do, as you can see that this is the class and input group I have used, and the quantity one is over here, and decrement button, increment button, right? And then simple, this is the input tag where we want to show the quantity input values, right? But value defaultly it stored one. But instead of one, we have to store our datas which we are taking from it. So as you can see that, let's copy this data quantity, water item quantity, what we are fetching, that we have to store over here. So insert this open curly, close curly braces and paste. Done. So now let us reload the page. This is because whatever default value when we are adding to cart, that time it should stop. So now let's reload the page and see what's the design. So let's reload. Cool. So the design has appeared now. Over here you can see the things, right? The text box and the increment and decrement design. Using Bootstrap I have done. So guys, now when we click on plus and minus, that time it should go up and down. So here itself we have pasted the code in step 2. So let's copy this. Copy and paste. Copy this and paste now. So we have linked into our JS file, custom JS, where we are pasting it. So let us paste over here. That's it. Done. So as you can see, when on click jQuery click function we are using, on increment button, where you can find that our cart page design is over here, increment button and decrement button. So this decrement button is in the next click. It's over here, right? So guys, now let's understand the increment button value. So where we are going to fetch that the parent quantity of that quantity input type of class, right? So this quantity is over here. Let's separate this again and again. It's disturbing to shift. Okay. Let me scroll it. Cider. Here it is. Here we go. Okay. So this is the quantity. The parent quantity is this, right? And inside this, we are going to find its class input quantity input value. So we are using the class, and you can find that class input is available here dot val, where we will take that values, and then after that we are parsing that increment value in parse int. Only integer numbers will take that value, and then we are checking with the is none, only number should be allowed. Okay, if other number is there, just skip and start doing with that. And the value is lesser or equal to less than 10. Okay, then value plus plus, and then increment that value inside this. Then as the output goes, and it will paste to that value thing. So guys, now let's test this once. So let me save. And then the same functionality goes with the increment and decrement also. So decrement means same thing, we will call that increment value, quantity of input value, and then pass it to where we are going to do value minus minus. Here for increment we did plus plus, and here minus minus, whatever the value we are getting it done. So let me just go and reload the page. So let's just check the output now. So I'm going to click on plus increment. Cool. So as you can see, it's incrementing, right? So till last, this design is I think little smaller. Let's see why it is. Okay, max 10 we have given, right? Here with 130 is there. I have made it, and you can see that 10 value also. So that was a small mistake. Not mistake, it's not responsive. So let's make it that as 150 instead of 130. So we can see the number of input, whatever the correct thing is. Let's give 140 itself. Save it and reload the page once again. So now loaded. Let's give the quantity 910. Cool. And let's decrement again, right? So as you can see that increment and decrement is working through this code. So finally we have completed how to make this quantity increment and decrement. Now in next video we will be learning about how to set up this when we click on this increment, that time the cart thing should get this into multiplied into 2, and the grand total will be 25 actually. See, 12 plus 12 24, where 55 plus 25, so 25,000. Here it should show the correct value, and here also it should increment, right? So guys, for that we will be learning in next video how to increment and decrement the price of it cart values. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like and share.